Good morning, fellow bikers. This is Sameer here at 5:15 in the morning. Saturday, hot, warm morning. Yeah. So, I'm going out for a day's ride today with my friend Rudradeep. Yeah, of course, you'll meet him in some time. It's dark now. I'm just going to rendezvous with him and then we'll go together, just the two of us, for a day's ride. And again, it's going to be a ride which is towards, well, not really Mysore area, but general direction, Mysore area, to a monastery, a Tibetan monastery. Well, no, not this monastery which you're thinking, which is close to Mysore on the way to Coorg. No, that's not the one. But a monastery called as Dzongshen Monastery. Not many people go there, but I did see some photos which I liked. And so Rudradeep actually, or Rudra, that's how I will refer him. Rudra basically said, let's go there. Oh, why not? And I was ready. So here we are, Saturday morning. We are going to go to Dzongshen Monastery, Tibetan monastery. And there are certain other monasteries also in its vicinity. I will share the names as we visit them, but the main monastery is Dzongshen. So looking forward for a good ride with Rudra, just the two of us, so not much of waiting time for anybody and stuff like that. So I will catch you at a breakfast time when there is daytime, so that I can introduce Rudra to you. And I hear that the road to Dzongshen is also very nice. I keep saying this, which I also did in the previous video. It's summer, so hopefully it stays green to enjoy. So we'll check that out. By the way, BR Hills is not very far from this monastery. So this monastery is in fact kind of at the foothills of BR Hills, if I may say so. So we'll check that out, okay? See you guys. Bye. So, good morning, folks. This is Rudra here. So, just the two of us going out there to Dzongshen Monastery. You want to open this? So, we are at the nice road toll gate moving towards Kanakpura. And yeah, we'll be stopping for our breakfast in probably less than an hour's time. Looking forward for the day, a very warm day for sure. So Rudra, all prepared? Chalo, let's go. Folks, I'm talking to Rudra via my Blue Armor headset, which by the way Rudra also owns. Very convenient to stay in touch with each other during rides, take phone calls, listen to music. Quality of the unit is fantastic. I have been using it for many months now. I am extremely happy with this unit. Rudra is also happy. He has some issue with sound from the day he has purchased it, but he is interacting with Blue Armor team. Hopefully they should resolve it. So catch you guys at breakfast, and the day is just dawning. I'm sure the sun will come out after some time, since nowadays it's been cloudy in Bangalore, but no rains at all. Okay guys, catch you later. Oh, so good morning folks again. A sunrise behind the clouds, as you can see. The rays are really shooting out, looking nice, but the sun is hiding behind the clouds. Again, quite high above the horizon, but luck is not on our side
for the time being I wanted to have the sunrise captured any which way. So both of us stopped out here. Hey Rudra! So both of us stopped here to hoping that the sun would pop out, but doesn't look like it's going to pop out very soon. And you can see the ravages of summer out here. This lake is normally quite filled with water, but it's slowly drying up, and I think in few weeks it will be dry, bone dry. Any which ways, enjoy this morning, a warm summer morning. Reaching Kanakpura in some time and then proceeding towards Thongchen Monastery. Wow, what a sight. Good morning, Mr. Sun. Nice to see you popping out of the clouds. The reflection in the water is looking sexy. I'm sure this camera won't be giving you justice, but I'll put a few snaps to give you the taste of the moment that we are seeing. Oh, look at the rays of the sun. Oh, beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful. Absolutely, the clearing. Finally, we got a good place outside the urban setup. The road leading to this lake was all full of buildings, and we were just thinking, where could we get a good spot to enjoy that sunrise? Finally, we managed to get a place. Whoa. Now we see the full circle, finally. So, guys, we had Mandarthi
Gardenia.
So it was a nice breakfast, dosa, coffee, fresh lime soda is going to be warm very soon, right? So it was important that we have something liquid which helps us. These are our bikes out here. So catch you soon on the way and meet you there at Monastery. So taking a short break, just a water break, because the sun is rising up and it's getting real by the minute, in fact. And if you see around you, not a single leaf is moving. Well, here there is such some slight movement, otherwise we could figure it out on the way. No trees are moving, there's no movement of this the wind at all. So it's going to be fun. As we reach the monastery, it's not very far, it's around 30 kilometers away, and we intend to reach there by around 10:30. Okay, we'll catch you there then. Bye. These trees look really nice and give the much needed shade. Wow! These are very different trees. We have not seen these type of trees anywhere else. Summers have really kicked in. Just look at the hills, they are right now bare. You have some greenery around the fields because I think they are obviously irrigated, but the hills are right now bare. The summer is showing its colors. Wow, it would be crazy to go out or venture out in these kind of forests right now. Yeah, the best locations to visit in this season is something like the monastery that we are going. It is a location that we are going rather than exploratory forests, right? Wow, it is getting hot, and we'll be reaching the monastery and still showing another 20 minutes away. The road is patchy in between. What you see now is quite good quality road compared to what we just passed through in patches.
where it really kills your speed and that is adding time to our arrival at our destination. Okay, I think my next update will be when we reach the monastery. Catch you there.
So folks, we are reaching the Tibetan monastery. Oh, look at this cultural confluence. We have a temple and here you have the arch for the monastery, the Dongchen monastery. Oh, wow, it's a beautifully decorated arch, a typical arch that you get to see at Mysore's Coorg's golden temple. Looks nice, well maintained, fresh colors. Dondeling, that's the name of the place, settlement, Dondeling Tibetan settlement. Quite a long list of things that you can see probably here. Looks nice. And they have this famous prayer wheel. Yeah, we will use it when we are on our return back journey probably. Wow, promising place, looks nice. I guess all of these houses are where the Tibetan settlers are. Look at the stark difference in the architectural style, right? And the colors being used. Just 100 meters away where the locals were staying, the houses were obviously very Indian looking, and some of the houses that you just saw were very different architecture. There in the distance you can see a lot of stupas. I'm sure we'll go there, the main monastery. Of course, this is the road that you take. I'm sure the camera is not giving justice to what I am trying to show you, but at least my bare eyes can clearly see a huge setup of the monastery with stupas, more and more settlements here. Wow. There in the distance, if you see, just across the field, you have the main monastery. Oh. Another prayer wheel. Looks nice. Look at this. So folks, a representation of the Tibetan settlement with the Himalayas out there. Nice way to put the message across. By the way, Om Mani Padme Hum, the holy inscription of the Tibetans is I do have a tattoo on my left arm, by the way. Had done it I think around 15 years ago. It's nice, cool. And there in the distance is one of the monastery, and the main monastery is out there, so that's where we are going. Yeah. Nice setup. Lot of land is what they have definitely got. Those stupas look very nice, quite impressive and big, I must say, from this distance itself. Ooh. This place is worth the visit in monsoon for sure. It's going to be lush green,
weather will be nice, clouds kissing the top of the mountains. It will be very nice. Definitely worth the visit again in monsoon. Whoa. Just look at this. Looks impressive. Just look at this, guys. Beautiful. I have to stop here, take snaps for sure. Welcome, village Nangchen. Let me park the bike here and I want to take some snaps here. Beautiful, look at these stupas. They are quite tall, easily what, 50 feet? And look at the surrounding, it's kind of in the middle of fields and settlements in a huge parcel of land. They look nice, clean, undisturbed. There are no locals around and absolutely no tourists like us. We are the only two guys, Rudra and myself. This definitely keeps the Tibetans' memories alive, right? You have the mountains, well, Tibet, Himalayas, stupas. Wow. Looking superb. These three, four stupas look to be freshly painted and maintained. Look at the vibrant colors, the golden glow. While I believe these stupas will eventually look the same, right? Once they are painted, they will also look nice in this grandeur. A typical gate of a monastery of the Tibetans. Wow. I'm kind of whispering because I'm not sure whether we are supposed to be inside this premise. There was no mold outside, it said not allowed or closed, and I don't want to disturb the peace around here, so I'm
kind of whispering. I hope the camera is able to get what I'm saying. So you have some settlements out here, rooms where I'm sure those monks stay. And then you have this monastery. The main doors seem to be locked, so I think the monastery is closed from, and we can't possibly go inside. But the exteriors itself are vibrant and colorful, as you can see.